Once we've run the ANOVA, it will generate an ANOVA table that is similar in its form to the ANOVA table that we saw with a one-factor ANOVA. The difference is that instead of having a single row of the factor that we are varying, there is a row for each of the main effects and also for the interaction effect. The number of columns and types of columns are the same. The way that these statistics are calculated is more complicated than the single factor ANOVA. We will not go into how that's done. You can refer to a statistics textbook if you're interested in the details of that. The interpretation, however, is similar. That is, we can look at the p-value for each of the main effects or the interaction effect and determine whether it's significant or not. In this example, the soap triclosan interaction is not significant. That means that it would then make sense for us to look at the individual effects of soap and triclosan. And so as it is shown here, soap would have a significant effect. Triclosan would not have a significant effect. Please keep in mind that these are fake data, so it doesn't really tell us anything real about soap and triclosan. This is just a made-up example, so don't draw any conclusions about the real effect of antimicrobial agents or soap from what I have said here.